Good morning, I'm Bianca LaDriga in for Poppy and Jim. After the delay, the damage. Today, a government shutdown is averted. But the president's holdup on signing the massive relief bill means some benefits for jobless Americans have lapsed. Millions could lose a week of critical aid. Struggling Americans caught in the middle of the president's chaotic final days in office, even if he doesn't think they're his final days. Even the New York Post telling the president to give it up and, quote, stop the insanity. And all this in the middle of a health crisis gripping our nation. December, the deadliest month in this pandemic, with more than 63,000 Americans dead so far. But after the holiday season, Dr. Fauci says he's worried darker days are ahead. We'll get all the angles covered coming up, but we begin with White House correspondent Boris Sanchez. He is in West Palm Beach this morning. Boris, good morning to you. There was no signing ceremony. The president clearly not touting this bill that he signed, but he still has his own demands. What are they?
Yeah, good morning, Bianca. After several days of delays, numerous Twitter rants, and several rounds of golf, the president ultimately relenting and signing this COVID relief bill last night. He says that he got several assurances from Congress that they will give in to some of his demands, including that they cut what he describes as unnecessary spending. Keep in mind, in a statement put out by the White House and several statements the president has made recently, what he's pointing to as so-called pork are items that the White House called for in their budget, so ostensibly items that the president approved Congress should spend money on. Secondly, he is asking lawmakers to work toward increasing those stimulus checks going directly to Americans from $600 to $2,000. Of course, keep in mind, so far, lawmakers have given no indication that they actually intend to pursue these items. But here's a piece of the statement that the president put out yesterday. He writes, quote, I will sign the omnibus and COVID package with a strong message that makes clear to Congress that wasteful items need to be removed. I will send back to Congress a redlined version, item by item, accompanied by the formal rescission request to Congress, insisting that those funds be removed from the bill. Keep in mind, Congress doesn't really have to do anything with that formal rescission request. After a certain amount of time, the bill that he signed goes into law. He also asked that Congress review Section 230, liability protection for social media companies, as well as, quote, focusing strongly on what he described as voter fraud. Again, there is no evidence of widespread voter fraud, and I think it's really notable that yesterday, after he signed this bill, the Senate Majority Leader, Mitch McConnell, praised the president in a statement, but he didn't mention any of these issues. There's really little incentive for Republicans to go after these demands from the president now, even though the president has gotten some support from Democrats for that rise in the stimulus checks from $600 to $2,000. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi talked about potentially putting that up for a vote in the House later today. Bianca.
Interesting that the man who wrote the art of the deal doesn't realize he has no leverage, given that he has already signed that bill. Boris, thank you so much.